Our DNP program at the University of Maryland School of Nursing started in 2006 as a postmaster's program, and we've graduated many cohorts of students. But now we're so excited that we're going to be offering a BSN to DNP program, and we are slated to open our new curriculum in the fall of 2014. Our curriculum is very integrated throughout the entire program. When students first start in the program, they're taking DNP-infused courses from the very beginning as they add their specialty and they go along with the DNP program. So again, I want to stress that we are doing this for our APRN, or Advanced Practice Registered Nurse programs at the University of Maryland. And of course, those are our MP and our Certified Registered Nurse Anesthetist programs. The MP programs that we are doing this with our rollout, include our Family Nurse Practitioner program, the Primary Care Adult Gero MP program, and as well we have an Acute Care Adult Gero MP and Integrated or Infused with CNS program. We also have Acute Care and Primary Care Pediatric MP, and as well we offer Psych Mental Health Nurse Practitioner. A DNP graduate will have the same degree on parity with a medical doctor, a PharmD, a physical therapist, all, again, educated at the doctoral level. At our case, our thoughts, our philosophies really originated from proclamations from the American Association of Colleges of Nursing, and even the Institute of Medicine report on the future of nursing from 2010. In which the recommendations were made then that nursing should be educated at the highest level in order to be national nursing leaders. And that's what our DNP graduates should be doing. They should navigate the healthcare system to help solve practice problems and to improve overall patient outcomes at the highest level, which is, again, at a doctorate level. At the University of Maryland School of Nursing, our BSN to DNP program will be focused on the APRN specialties, so the Advanced Practice Registered Nurse specialties, which at our school are defined as the nurse practitioner, the clinical nurse specialist, and the certified registered nurse anesthetist. One of the features of any DNP program is that students will not only take the different courses in their didactic course sequence, they will also complete about 1,000 hours of clinic time or practica hours as they focus on their particular specialty. Embedded in that, each of the MP programs, the students will take about 79 to 83 credits. The CRNA program inherently is quite longer. Full-time plan of study for 3 years because they have so many clinical cases that they have to complete, usually in the OR or a perioperative type setting. So their plan of study is a little more compact. It is still a full-time 3-year plan of study, and they complete many more than 1,000 hours of clinic as they're trying to complete their degrees. Students will have the option to either attend full-time in 3 years or part-time, and most of the part-time plans of studies will be defined as either 4-year or 5-year. So at the University of Maryland School of Nursing, our tagline is a degree of difference. And the reason we believe that is because rather than just combining programs and just globbing doctorate degrees on top of a master's degree, we fully integrated our curriculum so that students starting in the fall of 2014 will be taking doctoral level courses right from the beginning. So it's very exciting that when they graduate, they have a fully integrated curriculum to train them at the highest level to practice as APRN. Our DNP curriculum and our plans of study are rather prescribed. Students will be taking pretty established courses that are uniform throughout the country, actually. All APRN students have to take what we affectionately call the 3 P's. That's pathophysiology, pharmacology, and advanced physical assessment. Also, they will be immersed in both evidence-based practice methods, as well, all of them will take statistics courses. And again, all of that will be helpful in terms of their ability to rate and grade evidence and also critique and understand research as they go forward with their DNP degrees. Also, all of the students, because we believe that they are healthcare system experts, they will be also taking courses in nursing leadership, organizational systems and management, healthcare population, and as well they'll be taking courses in informatics so that they can understand how to navigate the very complicated healthcare system that we all exist in today. Also, our DMP students will take policy courses, and as well they will take courses to help them understand translational outcomes so that they can help translate findings to clinical settings in the future. In addition to that, all of our APRN students will also be taking diagnosis and management courses in their chosen specialty. That is a combination of both didactic courses as well as the clinical applications, so that they're directly applying the information they learn in their classes. They will have preceptors who help teach them clinically, as well as, of course, dedicated faculty that will help them in the clinical acquisition of skills and knowledge as they go forward with their DMP degree. I'd like to just talk a little bit about the differences between a DMP and a PhD. Now, I've talked a lot about DMP today. DMPs are all about translational science. They take the discoveries of others and apply them in a clinical situation. Of course, in our particular facility at University of Maryland, I'm again referencing the post-BSN to DMP, where they will be very focused on translational science. A PhD student, whether a student is in a biology or a chemistry degree, or in our case in nursing, a PhD in nursing, they're more about original research. They're learning how to conduct research as an original scientist, you know, conducting research with all of its rigor. It's very interesting in some schools, and certainly in ours, those two kinds of students can work together. The PhD student with its discovery, and then the DMP student can help apply that into actual real clinical situations. So it's a nice marriage. Students who will complete our BSN to DMP degree will have very, very interesting work opportunities. Of course, they're learning to be advanced practice nurses, either as MPs, CNSs, or a CRNA. Those students can easily be placed into primary care settings, providing direct patient care, in acute care settings, again with direct patient care, or they can be positioned in policy settings or educational settings, quality assurance settings. There are many opportunities. And of course, where we live, positioned nicely in Baltimore and very close to Washington, D.C. as well, Annapolis, Maryland, we have a very unique opportunity that we can expose our students to many policy and big organizations like HRSA, for example, where students have opportunities to impact national and local and, of course, regional legislation and politics.